also on the 16th, the eruption of the Mount Etna volcano in Sicily has forced the closure of nearby Catania Airport because of the plumes of ash billowing into the sky. On December the 17th, a massive sinkhole in Sichuan province opened up around Friday morning and had expanded into a crater measuring 60 by 40 metres and some 30 metres deep. The sinkhole has swallowed at least 12 buildings and is expected to keep growing in size. Tests have revealed in the United States that superbug bacteria is widespread in US chicken, says a consumer group. About half of the raw chicken breasts in a nationwide sampling carried antibiotic-resistant superbug bacteria, a US consumer group said on Thursday. It called for stricter limits on the use of the medicines in livestock. It could be more difficult to treat people if they became ill after eating chicken with the antibiotic-resistant bacteria, said Consumer Reports, which describes itself as the world's largest independent product testing organization. The group said it tested for six types of bacteria in 316 raw chicken breasts purchased from retailers nationwide during July. Almost all of the samples contained potentially harmful bacteria, it said. Some 49.7% carried a bacterium resistant to three or more antibiotics, according to the group, and 11% had two types of bacteria resistant to multiple drugs. Resistance was most common for the antibiotics used for growth promotion and disease treatment of poultry. No chicken for me. On the 22nd of December, two tornadoes touched down in Arkansas, injuring at least five people and damaging about two dozen homes. This was in St. Francis County. They were suspected to be tornadoes, and they injured three people near Hughes, a town of roughly 1,400 residents, about 35 miles southwest of Memphis in Tennessee. The 23rd, the Canary Islands. An earthquake swarm of about 120 quakes of magnitudes above 1.8, including a handful of possibly felt ones up to magnitudes of 3.2, have occurred since yesterday morning. If the volcano called Cumbre Vieja does erupt, a massive slab of rock would break away from the island of La Palma and smash into the Atlantic Ocean, causing a tsunami, a gigantic wave bigger than any recorded, scientists have warned. The resulting wave would devastate the eastern seaboard of America and inundate much of southern Britain, say scientists who have analysed the effects of a future volcanic eruption in the Canary Islands. On Saturday, the 27th of December, a 5.4 magnitude earthquake struck the Canary Islands, and it was one of the biggest ever they've had in the area of the El Hierro Cumbre Vieja volcano. It certainly appears that something is up, that something spectacular is imminent. Now, on the 24th of December, thousands of people in three provinces of Canada have been affected by ice storms that downed wires, damaged trees, and left them without power. Residents of Ontario, Quebec, and New Brunswick have spent the past few days struggling to keep warm. Most have gone without power since Saturday evening, when ice pellets started to fall in Ontario, coating trees in glistening ice. It's likely the world in the not-so-distant future will be increasingly populated by computerized people like Amal Grafstra. The 37-year-old doesn't need a key or password to get into his car, home, or computer. He's programmed to unlock at the mere wave of his hands, which are implanted with radio frequency ID tags. And we're seeing more of this now. Now, the implanted radio chips may be the way that humanity is controlled in the not too distant future in their buying and selling by the beast power of Revelation 13 in the Holy Scriptures. Now, you need to remember, the chip is not the mark of the beast. The mark of the beast is about worship. The chip is a control measure that can be switched off or on contingent upon whom you worship. whom you worship is and will always be the great issue. Worship God and the mark of his authority, and you will be penalized. Worship the beast power, and you will be allowed to buy and sell. The Holy Bible talks about a time coming when the people of the world will be forced to receive a mark either in their hand or in their head. Worship the beast power by assent, i.e. the metaphorical handshake, acceptance, or actual worship of the mark of his authority, that spiritual acceptance in the mind, and you will be able to buy and sell, for a while anyway. When all the people of this earth have made their decision whether to worship the beast and the mark of his authority, or worship God and the seal of his authority, then Jesus will come. In a new poll by Pew Research Center, just recently released, it's been revealed that 6 in 10 Americans believe humans and other living beings have evolved over time. 33% of Americans believe that humans and other living things have existed in their present form since the beginning of time, rather than evolving gradually through a process of natural selection, as described by Charles Darwin more than 150 years ago. And roughly a quarter of adults say that a supreme being guided the evolution of living things for the purpose of creating humans and other life in the form it exists today. The problem I find with evolution is that in the beginning there was nothing, and then nothing became something, and then spun around and a chunk of something flew off and it became the basis for our earth today. A chunk of rock. Then it rained upon the rock. The rock broke down over time and produced a primordial soup. Well, here's the problem. We need to back up. Where did the rain come from? Evolutionists don't know, but it's handy. But the problem is that you can't continue with your theory of evolution until you can answer this. If you're going to hang a theory out for viewing, you need something substantial in that theory, and I've not yet heard an evolutionist tell me where the rain came from. Just not good enough. I believe in the Creator God. This is the best scientific statement ever made. In the beginning, God created.
Troops in El Salvador are on standby. They are watching in the town of Las Placitas in San Miguel as plumes of smoke rise from the nearby Chaparastique volcano. The volcano began erupting on Sunday and is still belching ash and gas into the sky. Residents are following news of the volcano closely.
The wind is making the smoke and ash spread through this area. For our protection, we have to use face masks to avoid problems in our respiratory tracts.
The volcano has forced more than 1,600 people into emergency shelters. Most of those in this shelter are women, elderly residents, babies, and small children.
Due to yesterday's catastrophe, because of the volcanic eruption, we have families here from Canton La Moreta. Some 17 families are sheltered here. Yesterday, we had 89 residents of that region, and this morning, we only have
53.
Among El Salvador's 23 active volcanoes, Chaparastique is considered one of the most active. No major injuries or damages were reported.
The sun has undergone a complete field reversal, that is, its north and south poles changing places as it marks the midpoint of solar cycle 24. Experts say that the reversal of the sun's magnetic field is literally a big event, and it's a regular part of the solar cycle. While it may seem like the event could have a catastrophic repercussion for the galaxy, its effects are actually more subtle, mostly interfering with space exploration. Some researchers say cosmic rays are a danger to astronauts and space probes and might affect the cloudiness and climate of Earth. NASA has released a visualization of how the switch occurs. Beginning in 1997 and ending in 2013, it shows the green positive polarity switching with the purple negative polarity. Solar cycle 24 has been viewed as quite unpredictable. First, it came late by about a year, with extremely low activity recorded throughout 2009. This prompted astronomers to shift a predicted 2012 peak to 2013.